हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ईरर, डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ ईरर, हाउ वी कैन एक्सप्रेस ईरर एंड इफ देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड्स डिफरेंट ईरर वैल्यू फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स देन हाउ वी कैन ऐड डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ ईरर दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो. ओके, सो लेट्स कम टू द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. सो आफ्टर डूइंग मेजरमेंट्स वी हैव टू एक्सप्रेस द वैल्यू ऑफ फिजिकल पैरामीटर्स. So now the question is, how much confident I am about the accuracy of the measured value. So that means the measured value contains some error. So basically, errors are the measure of lack of certainty of a value. So now comes to the different kinds of error. So there are different kinds of error like systematic error, random or statistical error, and independent or dependent error. So we will discuss about these different kinds of error, that is systematic error, random or statistical error, and independent or dependent error. So systematic error. So systematic error, which is coming from every repetitive measurements. This is due to the because of calibration error of the instrument, zero error of the vernier or slide calipers, or error from experimenter side. Now next is random error or statistical error, which is coming from randomness or instability of the system or observed phenomena. So this random error is changing from one measurement to another measurements. So now the next is independent and dependent error. Okay, so let's understand using one example. Suppose you have one rectangle and you have to measure the sides of that rectangle. So you got the value of the sides like 50 cm with error value 1 cm. Another side is 20 cm with the error value of 1 cm. So this 1 cm error is independent error. And if we want to calculate the area of the rectangle, then the error value in area is a dependent error. That means the area is dependent on its sides. So that is, it's called dependent error. That means the error in side value is independent error and error in area value is a dependent error. Now the next is error estimation. That means whether it's random error or systematic error, and if there are different parameter, so that different error will come, then how can we add different kinds of error? So if we do single measurement, so the measured value may contain random error as well as systematic errors. So you have to find it out by doing experiments whether it's systematic error or random error. So systematic error, which can be detected by doing carefully the experiment, or different way to find the parameter and cross checking with previous parameter, so that one can sure about systematic error. And if the measured value is changing for every measurement, then there the error is probably a random error. Now come to the adding part. Okay, so if the that we discussed earlier, there are two types of error: dependent error, another one is independent error. So if the error value is dependent, then we can add linearly as source and of errors are same for every parameters. Okay, so if the operation is adding or subtracting, that means if the key formula of the experiment is like adding, for example here x plus x, that is 2x, so we can add the error value coming from x, that is delta x, and we can add so that we will get delta y, that is delta x plus delta x equal to 2 delta x. Or if the operation is subtracting, for example if the formula is y equal to x1 minus x2, then we can find the error value, that is delta y equal to delta x1 plus delta x2. Like that, if the operation is multiplying or dividing, for example, a equal to b into c, in this way, like to find the error in a, that is delta a, we can take log, then we can make it take the derivative of that log, so that we will get delta a by a, that is delta b by b plus delta c by c. Then if we multiply by a, multiply with a, that is delta a equal to a into delta b by b plus delta c by c, then we will get the error of a, that is delta a. Or another example is, if the formula is like y equal to fx, so you can take it derivative of y, that is delta y by delta x equal to f prime x, where f prime is f x plus delta x minus f x minus delta x by 2, that is delta y. Okay, so you can put the value of delta x and we can find the value of delta y. Or next is, if there are independent error from the different parameters, then we cannot add by using the summation, by using the sum formula as we did in dependent error cases. So in this case, they can add quadrature as source of errors are different and uncorrelated. For example, if the operation is adding or subtracting, initially we add delta x plus delta y. It was, if it is dependent error, then we can find the error in z, that is delta z equal to delta x by delta y. But in this case, as the error sources are different or independent, then first we have to find the value in error, that is delta x and delta y, then make them square, that is delta x square and delta y square, add them so that it will become delta x square plus delta y square, then make it root, take the root value, so you will get the value of delta z. Another one example is, if the operation is multiplying or dividing, for example, if the expression is z equal to x into y, then first find the value of delta x by x and delta y by y, then add them after making the square, so that it will become delta x by x square plus delta y by y square, then take the root value, so that you will get delta z by z. And to find the value of error value of z, that is delta z, you have to multiply with z, that is delta z equal to z into root over of delta x by x square plus delta y by y square. Okay, so if the operation is like formula, for example, if there is a function z, of function of x and y, then we can find the error value of z, that is delta z, using the expression like root over of delta x into delta f by delta x square plus delta y into delta f by delta y square, that is using the partial derivative. Okay, so here we can express the error using the average value, by taking the average value. Okay, let's see that. So here we have n number of measured value from x1 to xn. So first we can find the mean value, that is xm equal to x1 plus x2 plus ... xn divided by n, as there are n number of values. Okay, so the error value we can estimate in this way, like take the highest value and the lowest measured value and divided it by a factor of 2, take the difference of highest value and the lowest value and divided it by a factor of 2. That is x error equal to x plus, that is the highest value, minus x minus. X minus is the lowest value divided by 2. Okay, so that is the error value of in x. In other cases, if there are many measurements, so we can use the standard deviation formula. The formula is like sigma equal to root over of summation x1 minus x bar the whole square divided by n. So in this case, the error value is delta x bar equal to sigma n minus 1 equal to sigma root over of n minus 1. Here n is the number of measured value. Okay, now comes to the expression of errors. So as we discussed earlier, if there are many measurements, many data points, then we can express the error value using standard deviation. In this case, 60% of the measured value will lie within the standard deviation. Now next is absolute value. So if we express the error value as in the same unit as the value, then this kind of expression is called absolute value of expression. For example, if you have a rod of 10 meter length and if the error value is 1 meter, then we can express the whole things 10 plus minus 1 meter. So this is called absolute value of error expression. Next is percentage error. So if we express the error value as a fraction of the value, then it's called percentage error. For example, take the same example, you have a 10 meter length rod and error value is 2%. So we can express the error like this way, 10 meter plus minus 2%. So thanks for watching. If we enjoyed the video, please like. Thank you.